Hello friends, today I am here with Crop Production and Management Part 1 of 8th Standard. In today's session, we are going to discuss crop, types of crop, classification of crops, agricultural practices, and in agricultural practices, we are going to discuss here preparation of soil, sowing of seeds, adding manure and fertilizers, and irrigation. So let us start the session. First, it is about crop. When plants of same kind are grown and cultivated at one place and on a large scale, then it is called crop. Here you can see the crop field of wheat. Now, there are different types of crop. So, what are they? First is cereal crops like rice, wheat, maize, etc. Now pulses crops like grams, peas, beans, etc. Now vegetable crops, onion, potato, cabbage, etc. Fruit crops, apple, orange, banana, etc. Fiber crops, cotton, jute, etc. Oilseed crop, sunflower, mustard, groundnut. So these are the different types of crops. What are they? Cereal crops, pulse crop, vegetable crops, fruit crops, fiber crop, and oilseed crops. Here you can see the wheat crop, rice crop, maize crop, and different cereals. Here you can see the different pulses like gram. Now here you can visualize vegetables and fruits. Here also about the different fruits. This is about the fiber yielding plants, cotton and jute. Here it is the oil yielding plants, linum, sunflower, mustard, groundnut. Now next is about the classification of crops. Crops are classified into two types on the basis of seasons. And the two types on the basis of seasons, they are kharif crop and rabi crop. Kharif crops are those crops which are grown during rainy season. That is, sowing and harvesting is done between June and September. For example, paddy, maize, groundnut, cotton, soybean, they are the kharif crop. So their sowing season is June and harvesting season is September. Now, next is the rabi crop. These are grown during winter season. That is from October to March. Means sowing is done during October and harvesting is done in March. For example, wheat, grams, peas, mustard, linseeds, etc. Now let us see about the agricultural practices. Agricultural practices means those activities which are undertaken by the farmers for cultivation of crops. And the main agricultural practices are preparation of soil, sowing of seeds, adding manure and fertilizer, irrigation, protection from weeds, harvesting, storage. So here we are going to discuss the first four, that is preparation of soil, sowing of seeds, adding manure and fertilizer, and irrigation. So first agricultural practices is preparation of soil. And this preparation of soil is the first step before sowing the crop. So growing the crop, the first step is preparation of soil. We have to prepare the soil. So it is done by loosening and turning of soil, and this process of loosening and turning of soil is called tilling or ploughing. And this tilling or ploughing is done with the help of plow, hoe or cultivator. After ploughing, the soil are labeled using labelers. Now the question arises, why ploughing is necessary? Why ploughing is essential? So ploughing helps the root to grow deeper in the soil. and also to breathe easily, and it can absorb maximum nutrients from the soil, and it also helps in survival of useful microorganisms. So these are the benefit of ploughing. Here you can see the plough, hoe and cultivator. Here it is the ploughing through tractor. Ploughing is also done through the tractor. Now the next agricultural practices is sowing of seeds. Sowing means process of putting seeds in the soil. So it is the after preparation of soil, we have to put the soil, put the seeds in the soil. Farmer select a good quality and good variety of seeds for sowing. Why? Because there is a proverb, as you sow, as you ripe. So whenever one can select the good quality and good variety of seeds, then he will get a good variety of crops. Sowing is done by manually as well as mechanically. Manually, it is done with the help of hand by spraying the seeds, or mechanically by using seed drills. But there is benefit of seed drills. Seed drills helps to sow seeds uniformly and at proper distance and also at proper depth. And the use of seed drills prevent overcrowding of plants so that all the plants get enough oxygen, sunlight, nutrients, water, etc. Here you can see the hand sowing and also the sowing with seed drills. Now the next agricultural practices is adding manure and fertilizer to the soil. Why these are added? Because manure and fertilizer supply nutrients to the plants which are required for their proper growth and development. Whenever we grow crops continuously in a particular soil, particular area, then it becomes nutrient deficient. So it can be replenished by adding manure and fertilizers. So it helps in increasing the nutrient of the soil. Manure are organic substance and they are obtained by the decomposition of plants and animal waste by the action of microorganisms. And fertilizers are inorganic salts and they contain nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, etc. And they are made in factories. For example, the important fertilizers are urea, potass, ammonium sulfate, superphosphate, NPK, that is nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, it includes. So this is the about the manure and fertilizers. Now let us see what are the advantages of manure. Manure increases the water holding capacity of the soil and it also makes the soil porous for the exchange of gases. It helps the growth of useful microbes and also improve the texture of soil. Now let us see the difference between manure and fertilizer. There are a lot of difference. First, manure is biological in origin, whereas fertilizer is chemical in origin. Manure improves the texture of soil, whereas fertilizer do not improve texture of soil. Manure helps in increasing the water holding capacity, whereas fertilizer do not increase the water holding capacity. Manure is obtained by slow decomposition of plants and animal wastes, whereas fertilizers are obtained commercially in industry by combining different elements. Manure are absorbed slowly by the plant, whereas fertilizers are absorbed readily by the plants. This is the disadvantage of manure. Manure are bulky and voluminous, whereas fertilizers are compact and concentrated. Manure is not easy to transport, handle and use, whereas fertilizer is easy to transport, handle and use. Manure is cheaper, but fertilizer is costlier. Manure is not nutrient specific, whereas fertilizer is nutrient specific. Manure is sparingly soluble in water, whereas fertilizer is readily soluble in water. Manure is biodegradable, whereas fertilizer is non-biodegradable. Means manure can be decomposed by the action of microbes, whereas non-biodegradable, this fertilizer cannot be decomposed by the action of microbes. So they are not good for the soil. Manure is eco-friendly and do not causes pollution, whereas fertilizers are not eco-friendly and causes water as well as soil pollution. Manure do not kill useful organisms present in the soil, but fertilizer may kill useful organisms present in the soil. Manure do not change the acidity or alkalinity of the soil. The soil will become remain. But fertilizer may change the acidity or alkalinity of the soil. So overall, we can see that manure is better than the fertilizer. Here you can see the use of manure and fertilizers. Agriculture practices, next one is irrigation. Irrigation means supply of water to crops in the field. So whenever we supply water to the field, crop field, then it is called as irrigation. And this water is essential for the germination of seeds and proper growth of plants, as well as absorption and transportation of minerals to the different parts of the plants. There are different sources of irrigation like bell, tube well, ponds, lakes, rivers, dams, canals, etc. This agricultural practices is two types. One is traditional method of irrigation and other is modern method of irrigation. Traditional method of irrigation is by using moat, that is pulley system, chain pump, dekli and rahat, that is lever system. And modern method of irrigation includes sprinkler system as well as drip irrigation. And this modern method are used where the availability of water is less, and they also helps to reduce the wastage of water. So this is good. Here you can see the different sources of water: bell, tube well, river, canal. Here it is the traditional method of irrigation: dekli, chain pump, moat and rahat. Moat is the pulley system, whereas rahat is the lever system. This is the modern method of irrigation, that is a sprinkler system, and it is about the drip irrigation. Thank you. For any kind of doubts, please write your question in comment section.